Using Power BI also supports to get data from JSON file. You can click here to get data, go to More options, inform you want to take data from file, and then choose JSON. This way, we can import data from JSON file and work with that. So for this video, we are going to explore that using, as example, one dataset that is public available. It's available at this website here, in which gives us JSON datasets for exploratory OLAP. And then we are going to use this NBA games JSON file, in which we are going to perform a few explorations, like take the players for a certain team in a certain date period. So let's start.
Hi there, my name is Wafa, and I'm going to guide you through the usage of Power BI, how to import the data from this JSON file, and how to create visualization for our user to select one specific team or select some specific parent within the data set we have available, and then another visualization just for seeing the set of players that met the defined filters. Now, let's start on that.
The first step is the data import. We are going to use this get data for taking one specific file type that is JSON. Clicking here, Power BI will prompt for the selection of the JSON file in your computer. The JSON file I have just downloaded, it's here. So it selected this file. And now we have to wait because this file is long. It has 1,000 entries with more than 200 megabytes of data. So Power BI is preparing that for we import and give us the chance for performing transformation in this data. So here is a sample of data set available. There are a lot of columns. This text file here, as it's a prepared data set, it's already well formatted in the meaning we have the fields defined. The data type of the fields is also okay. We don't need to perform conversions here. Everything is well defined, the numeric values are as numbers, the text values is as text, the date values is already like date, so it's okay. What are the columns we are going to work in the example we are going to do in this video? We are going to work with the team name for filtering the team name. We are going to use the last column here, that's the date, that's the paired players has worked in this video, and then the last column we are going to use is the player name, that is here. So based on these three columns, we are going to perform the whole example. Once you have identified your data set and everything's okay, you just has to click here and close and apply, and then start the creation of your dashboards.
Now the data import has been concluded. We have here in the right side the columns available. So first thing we are going to do is allow the user to select the team name. So we can just take here some visualization like this table. Okay, just select the table visualization, and then we can just take these team name field and drag and drop that to here. Now it's going to show all team's name entries available for user to select that. Okay, it's a first visualization. Now, more than that, we want the user to select the time, the date period in which the players has played at this team. For this purpose, you can choose some kind of visualization like this slicer run. This slicer run is very interesting for this purpose. You can then just click here in this slicer And now we have to choose here a field, and then we are going to choose this date field. As you can see here, it automatically creates some kind of data paired filter from the first date we have data available to the last date we have data available. And now we can create another visualization for showing the players, but just the players that met this team and this date. So we can create a third visualization. It could be again a table. In this table, we are going to show the player name. The player name is going to be available at the teams, players, and then there is the player name someplace here. We just have to look for that player here. Then we just drag and drop the player to here. Here it brings the player name from all the data we have available, but then we are going to use the filters. And as filter, we are going to use the same fields we have selected in the another visualization, like the team name as a filter, and also the date as a filter. Now it's going to show only the players that met some specific selected team and some selected date paired. It could be easier for testing and debugging, we can say like that, if we add more columns here. So just for debugging purposes, for having sure the data presented here really met the selection we have done. So it could also ask to show here the team's name and ask to show here as well the date. So we can just validate if the date paired and the things displayed here in third visualization met the filters we have defined. So in case I select here some specific team like Dallas Mavericks, now do you see here it's filtering that just players from Dallas Mavericks are available here. Okay. More than that, we have the raw data from all this paired. But now let's suppose we want to have the data just from the year of 2006. So we can use the slicer to go 2006 here and reduce the end date for 2006 as well. Just a little more here. Okay, it's okay. And now, as you can see, it's reducing again the data available. So just players that has played in this period. Here we have duplicated names, but it's because we have more columns here. In case we don't want to see duplicated entries, we may configure that. For instance, we could, from this visualization here, take out the date. Now, each array is better. Each player shows just once, and here just the set of players that has played in this scene and in this data paired. So it's a quite useful dashboard for navigating through the JSON dataset. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.